Morning students. So in continuation to the previous session, in this session let me explain different types of belt drives. So in particular flat belt drives. Later on we will see the other types of belt drives, V belt drives, then circular belt drives. So first one is the open belt drive. When you want to transmit power from driving shaft to driven shaft, and both are parallel to each other and both are rotating in the same directions, right? When the driving shaft and driven shaft both are rotating in the same directions and are parallel to each other, then the power transmission can be possible only by using a flat belt drive. So here, as we have studied already, the shaft of the driving member is nothing but a shaft connected to the prime mover. This is a driving shaft. The other name for driving shaft is the line shaft. And this is the shaft which is connected to the machine. So that's why this is called a machine shaft. And the other name is driven shaft. So two pulleys, driving pulley and driven pulley, both are mounted on driving and driven shafts, right? So look at these arrows, both the pulleys are rotating in the same direction. So that is the clockwise direction. And the shaft's orientation is perpendicular to the plane of figure or the perpendicular to the viewer. Both the shafts are perpendicular to the plane of figure. That means both are parallel to each other. When the two shafts are parallel to each other and the power transmission takes place in the same sense, that means both are in the clockwise or anti-clockwise direction, then open belt drives are preferred. So as I said earlier, the bottom side of the belt drive should be tight side and the top side should be slack side, right? So this is open belt drive. Next, the second one is cross or the twist belt drive. So it is similar to your flat belt drive in the sense both the shafts are parallel to each other. I mean the shafts are perpendicular to the plane of figure, but the direction of rotation of driving and driven pulleys are exactly opposite to each other. Let us have a look on this figure. The driving pulley rotates in the clockwise direction, whereas the driven pulley rotates in the anti-clockwise direction, right? So the flat belt, which is placed over the pulleys, crossed at the center, So due to this crossing, there is a chance of rubbing. So this rubbing causes the failure of the belt. That's why there is a limitation in the length and width of the pulleys. The shaft should be placed at a maximum distance of 20 times that of the belt width. So that is the one of the condition when you consider cross belt drive, right? And the speed of the belt should be less than 15 meters per second. This is another condition when you want to select a cross belt drive. Okay, so but depending on the requirements, requirements in the sense the direction of rotation of machine shaft or the driving shaft, you can consider either the flat belt, open belt drive or cross belt drive. Okay, I think it is understood, right? Next, the third one is a quarter turn belt drive. So when the two shafts, the driving and the driven shafts, or when the line shaft and the machine shaft turn. So here I am frequently using a line and machine shaft because the line shaft is the shaft connected to the prime mover, and the shaft connected to the machine, which consumes power, is called the machine shaft. So the driving shaft is nothing but driving shaft, line shaft. Driven shaft is nothing but machine shaft. So based on the orientation, we have been classifying these shafts as flat, open belt drive, cross belt drive, and the third one is quarter turn belt drive. Quarter turn belt drive. And the shafts are at right angles to each other. The shafts are perpendicular to each other. The quarter turn belt drive is used. Right? So look at this figure. Here, this is the driving shaft or the driving pulley. The driving shaft is the perpendicular to the plane of figure, right? So like this, and the driven shaft is parallel to the plane of figure, parallel to the plane of figure. So that means the one is the perpendicular to the plane of figure and other one is parallel to the plane of figure. Now if you want to transmit power from this shaft to this shaft, you need to use or we have to select a quarter turn belt drive, since quarter of turn, right, is considered in belt orientation. That's why this belt drive is known as quarter turn belt drive, right? But the main problem with this type of belt drive is the orientation of the belt on the pulley surface. It is very difficult, and the placing of belt over the pulley surface without causing the slipping is very much difficult compared with the open belt drive and the cross belt drive. So that's why so a separate provision is made here with the help of another pulley called guide pulley. Right, so this guide pulley just guides the belt, the direction of the movement of the belt. So this is another kind of quarter turn belt drive with a guide pulley. So here the power transmission is similar to this, but look at the orientation of these two. So this is a shaft parallel to the plane of figure, and this is also a shaft parallel to the plane of figure, but both the shafts are perpendicular to each other. So in this type of power transmission, a guide pulley, which is used to guide the movement of the direction of belt movement. So the function of this extra pulley is the guiding of the belt. So that's why it is called quarter turn belt drive with a guide pulley. So one of the important factor you need to remember here when you use a quarter turn belt drive, the width of the face of the pulley should be greater than or equal to 1.4 times that of belt width. Then only you can keep the belt on the surface of the pulley. Otherwise, there is a chance of slippage, right? So the next one is belt drive with idler pulleys. Belt drive with idler pulleys. Idler pulley means so it will not perform or it is not used in the functioning of this belt drive. It is just idle. So there is no movement at all for this pulley. Then what for this idler pulley is used in the belt drives? That is the question here. So the function of this idler pulley is just to maintain a larger angle of contact or arc of contact on the smaller pulley. Since the open belt drive, so it is a kind of open belt drive. So look at this, both the driving and driven members are rotating in the same direction and the shafts are parallel to each other, but it is very difficult to maintain the tight side at the bottom of the belt drive because of slackness in the belt. So due to this, there is a chance of getting a lower value of angle of contact, which affects the power transmission and velocity ratio in the belt rise. Hence, a separate pulley called idler pulley is placed in line with the parallel to the driving and the driven pulleys. So, which is just in contact with the belt surface, which is used to just to guide the belt movement with a slight deviation from the earlier one, so that the angle of contact on the smaller pulley will be increased, so that you can increase the velocity ratio or the power transmission. Okay, so the same type of arrangement, idler pulleys, the number of idler pulleys are used when you want to transmit power from a driving member to number of machine shafts or number of driven shafts parallelly. These idler pulleys are considered at different locations depending on the application. So this is belt drive with idler pulley, where you want to transmit power from one driving member to number of driven members. So here the primary is only one, but at the consuming end you have three driven pulleys. Got it? So next one is a compound belt drive. So this compound belt drive consists of a number of pulleys, right? More than two pulleys. Apart from the driving and the driven pulleys, there are intermediate members here, intermediate pulleys, right? And the power transmission takes place from driving end to driven end with the help of an intermediate shaft. Okay. So this intermediate shaft provided with two more pulleys. One will be considered as a driver and second one will be considered as the driven one. So that means two types of open belt drive. Two open belt drives are combined to get a compound belt drive. With this, you will get a larger speed reduction ratio. So that is the advantage of compound belt drive. When you want to get more amount of larger speed reduction ratio, then you can go for a compound belt drive. Okay, so this is next. Sixth one is stepped or cone pulley drive. So this you might have seen in the lathe machine, where you want to vary the speeds of the lathe machine or the speed of the spindle in the lathe machine. The belt is shifted from one shaft to another shaft, right? So this stepped cone pulley drive is used when you want to get different speeds without stopping the driving member or the line shaft. Okay, the driving or the line shaft continues to run without any interruption, but the speeds at the driven end are varied by changing the belt from one step to another step, right? And pulleys used in the stepped or cone pulley drive are made in the form of steps. It resembles like a cone, or it resembles like a stepped shaft. That's why it is called a stepped pulley drive or a cone pulley drive. Okay, it is mainly used when you want to vary the speeds at the driven end without interrupting the functioning of a driving member, right? So this is a stepped or cone pulley drive. And the next one is fast and loose pulley drive. So here, fast and loose pulley drive, there are two pulleys here, fast pulley and loose pulley, right? So this is a driving shaft and this is driven shaft. So the driven shaft is mounted with the two kinds of pulleys, right? As the name suggests, fast pulley and loose pulley. Fast pulley is key to the shaft. As the driven shaft rotates, the fast pulley also rotates because there is an intermediate element called key. Whereas the loose pulley is free to rotate on the surface of the driven member without transmitting the rotation to the driven shaft, or it is not involved in the power transmission. The loose pulley is just to carry the belt without transmitting the power, right? And here this is a driving shaft or the line shaft, which runs continuously, right? So when you want to stop the movement of the driven shaft, or when you want to stop the rotation of the driven shaft, or when you want to stop the power transmission without interrupting the power production from the prime mover, or without interrupting the movement of the rotation of the driving member, if you want to stop the power transmission, the belt is pushed on to the loose pulley with the help of lever from the fast pulley. So when you want the power transmission, the belt is placed on the fast pulley. When you don't want to transmit the power from driving end to driven end, the belt is shifted or pushed on to this loose pulley with the help of a lever with the belt forks, right? This kind of arrangement you might have seen the agriculture pump sets in years back, some 10 to 20 years back, the borewells are provided with, borewells where the submergible pumps are not that much familiar. The engine is coupled to the centrifugal pumps and the water is pumped from the wells. In this case, the engine shaft is connected to the pump shaft, and the pump shaft is mounted with two types of pulleys, a fast pulley and loose pulley. So without interrupting the running of engine, you can stop the water pumping of the centrifugal pump by switching the belt to fast pulley and loose pulley. So this kind of fast and loose pulley drive is widely used in the agriculture pump sets. Right? I hope you understood the different types of belt drives. Okay, thank you.